Okay. On September 20th at about 4:30 or 5 p.m., I was east of Prince George, headed west towards Prince George. And I was in a line of traffic, probably going about 90 km approximately. And I saw this animal or creature on the side of the road. But I didn't know what it was. It was very big. I could tell that. And it looked to be really wide. And when I saw it, I thought, well, it must be a moose or an elk. Like, and I was waiting for its head to emerge somewhere, you know, like, didn't happen. No head. Like, this, what it looked like was massive shoulders and arms. I could only see down as far as the elbows, guessing their elbows. And it looked like this. That's what it looked like. I didn't spend a lot of time on the drawing, but it gives you a pretty basic idea of what I saw. And my thinking at the time is, what the fuck is that thing? And, it was kind of walking alongside the highway, same direction I was going from the look of it. And then it turned sideways, and this is what I saw. Like, I saw this face, fairly fine-featured face, actually. The way I drew it isn't really accurate. Like, a, you know, not as heavy a nose as that, but and I didn't actually see the eyes. I don't remember what color they were. I just made blue eyes on him because I never actually saw his eyes. I could see his nose and chin and cheekbones. And there was this kind of wispy blonde tan beard hanging off it kind of thing. When they, like when I first seen it, there was a, the sun was shining. It was like, you know, late in the day, but sun was getting low, and the hair on the top of the back was really kind of glowing in the sun, you know? The sun was shining through it, and when it turned, I could really see the blonde hair on its chin, tan blonde, and its face was tan color, like tan, like white-tailed deer. And, yeah, it was very strange. I've spent a lot of time in the bush, and I had never seen one of those before. I mean, I've heard of them, and I know some very rational people that have seen those. But, I mean, all the camping and hunting and exploring and, you know, sightseeing, I just hadn't seen one. 57 years old, driving down the road, I see one. So, I mean, I used to be kind of a skeptic, but, you know, I've just come to meet more and more people who are rational, you know, normal people who, I mean, why would they say they saw something like that if they didn't, right? And now I've seen one. And so I know these creatures are out there. What was striking to me was why I couldn't see its head on top of its shoulders. I don't know if it had its head kind of down or if that's just the way that creature was built. very strange. You know, all of the illustrations I have seen in that footage of that one, those guys got footage of, like, back in the 60s, like, that one's head was well on top of their shoulders. This one, his head was, like, down in his chest area down here, you know, like, at the top of his head did not protrude above his shoulders, which was peculiar. So, all I can think is that these creatures are all individuals. They're not all going to look the same. Why would they? I mean, we don't all look the same. We have similarities, but we are unique. You know, we have our eye color, build, hair color, you know, like, so. And the strange thing about it, like, I never saw this thing's hands, so all I could see was kind of like from the waist up over the guardrail there, right in the corner at Wansa Creek. I kind of wish I had seen them, but, you know, like, because of the rate of speed, I didn't get a really long look at it. And when I realized what I'd seen, I was kind of processing the experience, and like, I kind of wanted to go back and look for tracks, but, you know, I drove quite a ways before I made that decision, and I did go back, and I parked in front of the guardrail. I'm right on that corner where Wansa Creek is, and I walked back, and I realized that it was a downhill slope down to the creek beyond the guardrail and down to where this massive culvert is that the creek flows through under the road, under the highway. And in order for me to see that creature, as much of it as I saw, it had to be 10 to 12 feet high. And I thought, I don't really want to step over that guardrail. Like, if that thing is in the area, I don't want any obstruction between me and my truck, you know. The way I've drawn this, you'll notice, like, okay, these shoulders, from my estimation, from going back and looking at the area, you know, I would guess them to be at least 4 feet wide, maybe as much as 5 feet wide. And when it turned sideways like that, when I could see its face, it was easily 3 to 3.5 feet straight through the chest. That's how deep the chest on this thing is. Massive creature. I would guess incredibly powerful. Like, I would, if there was a fight between that and a grizzly, I would put my money on that. Like, I think it could just rip a grizzly in half and casually throw both halves away, you know? Like, yeah. I don't know what they are. I mean, I know what they're called. I know they exist. Like, it's confirmed to me now. Whether they be Nephilim, like the Bible explains, describes. Not an ape. Not a gorilla. And highly intelligent, I suspect. Very likely in possession of physical and mental abilities that I can only guess at. Like, it kind of undecided whether I really want to upload this, because... I mean, okay, I've been called lots of names in my life. Lots of them not so good. You know, it's just the way people are, right? And I dish it right back, so... I don't know, like... I guess I'm just one of those people that saw one of these things. And... I know they're out there. And that's it, really, you know? I got nothing else. I'm still gonna go out there. But I'd rather not have an up close face to face with one of those. Yeah. But I feel the same way about grizzly bears or black bears or cougars, so, or skunks. Yeah. Hell, even a rutting moose could be a real danger, you know, so. Huh. Just another one of crazy things about this planet that has been revealed to me. That's it.